Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. While the 100-day countdown to the presidential primary is underway, voters in some New Hampshire cities will be heading to the polls tomorrow. And the state's largest city, it could be a record turnout. WMUR's Ray Brewer had a chance to catch up this morning with two candidates for mayor of Manchester.
With less than 24 hours before the polls open, challenger Joyce Craig spent part of her morning meeting and greeting voters along Elm Street. After months of campaigning, Craig says she's ready for the voters to have their say.
I'm glad it's here. We've worked hard. We've ran a very, honest, positive campaign. Had a great group of volunteers, so we're ready.
Holding an election sign that he's had since 1999, Mayor Ted Gatzis was waving to voters at one of the city's busier intersections. Gatzis also believes the voters are ready to make their decision.
I can tell you the voters out there are happy it's tomorrow.
The voters have had many opportunities to compare the candidates side by side, such as this debate. As such, both candidates think the issues have gotten a lot of exposure. And as to what they want the voters thinking about when they head to the polls.
But there's a great opportunity here in Manchester with new leadership. A mayor who's going to listen to voters, listen to their concerns and their ideas, and implement those ideas.
We are better off today than we were 6 years ago. There are great things that are happening in the city of Manchester, and we will continue growing on that base.
And depend on News 9 for complete coverage of the mayoral races. Right now at WMUR.com, you'll find video pitches from the candidates along with info for each key city race in the state. And when you are on the go, don't forget to download our free WMUR mobile app. Several presidential candidates will be in New Hampshire this week. Marco Rubio and Carly Fiorina will return to file for the primary election later this week. And Martin O'Malley and Jeb Bush will also visit the state, but they are not expected to file until later this month. A traffic note, if your commute takes you across the Sarah Long Bridge between Portsmouth and Kittery, you may need to find an alternative route. Inspectors are working on the bridge today through Friday. Lane closures will take place between 8 in the morning and 3:30 in the afternoon. Starting tonight on News 9 at 5, with smartphones and mobile devices becoming more common, do you know how much screen time your kids are really getting? And if you're overwhelmed by all of the Halloween candy at your house, we have some ideas, including ways to turn it into healthier treats. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.